For the first time in more than 6 months, SpaceX has stacked both stages of its next-generation Starship rocket, creating the largest and most powerful launch vehicle ever fully assembled. It's not the first time. SpaceX has conducted three other, full-stack, Starship demonstrations. Once in August 2021 and again in February and March 2022. Join us as we bring you, SpaceX fully stacked Starship rocket for the first time in 6 months. But earlier this year, SpaceX, or at least CEO Elon Musk, decided to give up on the Starship upper stage and Super Heavy booster prototypes that had supported all three of those prior tests and, at one point, been considered a candidate for the rocket's first orbital launch attempt. Booster 4 and Ship 20 were consigned to a retirement yard by June 2022. By then, SpaceX had already begun testing the new favorites for Starship's orbital launch debut, Super Heavy Booster 7 and Starship 24. Almost exactly 6 months after the start of that busy period of testing, both prototypes recently reached the point where SpaceX was confident enough in their progress to combine the two for the most challenging phase of Starship testing yet. After an aborted pre-dawn attempt on October 11, SpaceX technicians worked out some mystery kinks in crucial infrastructure, located at Starship's first nearly finished orbital launch pad in Boca Chica, Texas. As part of a cart-before-horse gamble made by CEO Elon Musk, that has seen SpaceX entirely remove legs from all recent Starship and Super Heavy prototypes, in the hope that it will one day be able to catch the building-sized rocket stages out of midair. The company has built a launch tower approximately 145 meters, approximately 475 feet tall, and outfitted it with three giant robotic arms. Two of those arms are identical and linked together, forming a sort of claw that could one day close around hovering rockets to preclude the need for landing legs. A simpler third arm swings in and out to connect Starship's upper stage to the launch pad's power, propellant, and gas supplies. The chopsticks, as they're known, have another even more important purpose, assembling Starship rockets at the launch pad. Thanks to their sturdy connection to a tower, with a foundation sunk deep into the Boca Chica wetlands, and a design that foregoes a hanging hook or jig for giant arms, they are far less sensitive to winds than the immense crane, otherwise required to stack Starship on top of Super Heavy. Sitting a stone's throw from the Gulf of Mexico, storms and high winds are not exactly uncommon. Around sunset on October 11, SpaceX had better luck on its third attempt and was able to move the arms into place under Ship 24. Weighing 100 tons, or more approximately 220,000 plus pounds, and measuring 9 meters wide and approximately 50 meters tall. The Starship was then slowly lifted about 80 meters, approximately 250 feet off the ground, translated over to Booster 7, and lowered on top of the 69-meter-tall, approximately 225-foot first stage. After about two more hours of robotically tweaking their positions, the two Starship stages were finally secured together. With the arms still attached to Ship 24, SpaceX workers were able to approach the rocket and prepare to connect the swing arms' quick disconnect umbilical to Starship. Since they began qualification testing in April and May 2022, Booster 7 and Ship 24 have each completed several cryogenic proof tests, 8 spin primes of some or all of their Raptor engines, and several static fires of those same engines. Most recently, Ship 24 ignited all 6 of its Raptors, but the seemingly successful September 8th test was followed by more than a month of apparent repairs. Booster 7 last completed a static fire that ignited a record 7 of its 33 Raptor engines, offering an idea of how much further SpaceX still has to go to finish testing the Super Heavy. According to CEO Elon Musk, Booster 7 and Ship 24 will attempt Starship's first full-stack wet-dress rehearsal, once all is in order. The prototypes will be simultaneously loaded with around 5,000 tons of liquid oxygen and methane propellant and then run through a launch countdown. Diverging just before ignition and liftoff, a WDR is meant to be more or less identical to a launch attempt. If the wet dress rehearsal goes to plan, SpaceX will then attempt to simultaneously ignite all 33 of the Raptor engines installed on Super Heavy B7, almost certainly making it the most powerful liquid rocket ever tested. Even if all 33 engines never reach more than 60% of their maximum thrust of 230 tons, they will likely break the Soviet N-1 rocket's record of 4,500 tons of thrust at sea level. It would also be the most rocket engines ever simultaneously ignited on one vehicle. SpaceX will be pushing the envelope by several measures, and success is far from guaranteed. It's unclear if SpaceX will immediately attempt a full wet dress rehearsal, or 33-engine static fire. Based on the history of Ship 24 and Booster 7 testing, it would be a departure from the norm, if the company doesn't slowly build up to both major milestones, with smaller tests in the interim. At minimum, assuming wet dress rehearsal testing is completed without major issue, SpaceX will likely attempt at least one or more interim static fires, with fewer than 33 engines before attempting the first full test. If both milestones of full WDR and 33-engine static fire are completed, without significant issue, there's a chance that SpaceX could move directly into preparations for Starship's first orbital launch attempt, without unstacking the rocket. In the likelier scenario that some issues arise and some repairs are required, the path will be more circuitous, but should still end in an orbital launch attempt late this year or early next. But, SpaceX founder and chief engineer Elon Musk said that the debut orbital launch could happen as soon as next month. November seems highly likely, he said. We will have two boosters and ships ready for orbital flight by then, with full stack production at roughly one every 2 months, he shared via Twitter on September 21. Now that Starship SN24 is stacked atop Booster 7, the next big test is probably full-stack wet dress rehearsal, then 33-engine firing in a few weeks, said Musk. The weeks ahead are expected to be exciting in terms of Starship development. The company aims to achieve launching Starship to orbit before this year comes to an end. One or several more tests will also be required, if SpaceX decides to gradually build up to 33 engines. Which is the approach that all Booster 7 activity to date suggests SpaceX will take. Either way, it will be a major challenge for SpaceX to have a fully stacked Starship, ready to launch by the end of November. If any significant problems arise during any of the several unprecedented tests, described above, Musk's predicted schedule will likely become impossible. As a wildcard, the Federal Aviation Administration has yet to issue SpaceX a license or experimental permit for orbital Starship launches, either of which is contingent upon dozens of mitigations. This isn't to say that it's impossible for an orbital Starship launch attempt to occur in November. But factoring in the many issues Booster 7 and Ship 24 have experienced during much simpler tests, it's becoming increasingly implausible SpaceX will be ready to launch the pair before the end of 2022. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.